Still in VF? 20 minutes.
Continue trust conversions.
Refib charge 360. Clear. Asystolic. Zero output.
Nothing.
Dr. Thomas?
We go again.
We stop. Team direction assured and timely. No patient could ask for more. Okay, put Mr. D back in his box and everybody report to me in my office for analysis. Onward and upward.
You did good, Cat.
Yo, Cat! Ever made it with a step?
Jesus.
Harris. I'm sorry. I meant to ring you. It was very close, if that's any consolation.
No. Is your wunderkinder? Our jobs are safe.
With me.
So what's with Harris? His last research project was high on ambition, low on patient safety. They pulled the funding, transferred him here.
Yeah, with the rest of us rejects.
The adrenergic effects of first-line drugs on cardiac arrest are...
augment coronary diastolic pressure, increase of endocardial perfusion during compression.
Tell me that isn't your best shot.
Show off?
Jesus, you two fucking eggheads need to get out a whole lot more.
Oh, Harry, quiet subtly.
All right, enough already. Tonight, we party.
A fucking man. I can't. I need to research why Mr. D didn't make it today.
Kat, you do know that Mr. D is brain dead and made of plastic, right? Like every fucking man?
Fuck Mr. D.
Something I'm sure you've considered, Harriet.
No way. I'm still waiting for Mr. B to call me. I feel so used.
Jake's gonna be there.
And?
Oh, I'm sick of this. I'm too busy for a boyfriend bullshit. He's hot. You're hot. Make it happen.
Yeah, okay. Put out already. Those John Hopkins sluts, I'll eat him alive. Thanks.
Creeping around like this?
Hello. Catherine.
He's horrible, Vince.
Do
Typical Catherine. Bring me your waifs and strays and your unwashed masses. Next thing you know, you'll be giving a bum a bed or an orphan.
Harriet!
Jesus, God, I'm sorry.
Don't worry about it.
Hey, Walt, working first class tonight. I'm impressed.
One night only. Back to the underworld tomorrow.
Safe home.
See ya.
Jealous?
Look it?
Yeah?
Then that answers that question.
So, today, you see Kat in the air today? She's in the zone like that, all full of passion. She's incredible, right?
Yeah, she's very impressive.
No, not as impressive as research fellowship at Johns Hopkins.
Possible research fellowship at Johns Hopkins, but thank you. Yes, it's very cool.
Oh, you deserve it. But we'll miss you.
Well, I'm not gone yet. You got me for a month.
What do you say, guys? Prognosis? Wasted.
Fuck yeah. Type. She's got a pulse. Fucking freak dog. Guys.
You have a potty mouth.
Yeah, I'm crushed. Fuck off. Thanks, Kenneth, but I'm just gonna hang out here for a while.
Sure, yeah. Oh, okay. Having a party, right?
Yeah, that's right. You're not invited.
You're still here? We're close.
He's just leaving.
Enjoy your party.
We will. Adios, loser.
The guy's a fucking freak, dog.
And your drug, Sean.
Keep walking, retard.
The ones that are in your pocket. The ones from the pharmacy. The ones you probably shouldn't have.
You're deluded.
No. See, I I recorded you.
Hey! I said we're close!
Okay.
This guy's out of control.
Shit, guys. Hospital policy is zero tolerance. Guys, this is really bad.
Shit.
Man, what a fucking mess.
Slow down, okay? The hospital doesn't know.
Not
Yes.
Gotta get him back. Catherine.
What?
Come on, I liked you.
Catherine, seriously.
Inside, and we can all talk and hang out.
Me?
Yeah, you.
Okay.
Come on.
Justify a night of passion, that's up to you.
I don't remember any passion.
Don't worry, I do.
Just go fuck him up.
Hey, Sean, Kenneth's fine, so just leave him. It's cool.
Sure about that, Captain?
I'm not taking any chances.
Yo, Kenny! Wanna sip cow's piss with the old ladies?
Or you wanna play with the big boys? You got some catching up to do, my friend.
Kenneth, you don't have to do this.
God, are you his fucking mom? Thank you.
Come on, Kenny. You're one of us, boy. Get in here. Get a hold of that.
Yeah, get up here. Yeah.
Yeah, Kenny boy. We like that.
Hey.
Get it up. Come on.
You okay?
Kenny. Come on. Get in here.
It'll be fine.
Oh, yeah. It's the freak dog.
Okay, keep the fuck calm. Okay, when I cut, reach it. Steve, don't be nuts.
Steve, ignore him. He's a tracheostomy
now. Steve!
Shut up, Sean.
You do this, Steve, you might as well write your fucking name on him. Cat, no. Just listen.
Get
Sean, no.
Sean, what the hell are you doing?
Cat,
he needs help.
Jesus, Sean, what the hell are you doing?
Fuck off me.
Wait, look. His airway's cleared. I think he's still breathing.
All right, fuck this. I'm calling an ambulance.
Jake, we're high as shit. We're with the guy pumped full of stolen hospital drugs. How's that gonna look?
Oh, fuck.
We don't have time to wait. Let's go.
We call an ambulance, we're officially involved. It's on the record. They have to act. Make an example. Zero tolerance, zero exceptions. Daddy might not be able to buy you out of this one, Kim. Hell, he might not even want to. Talking to daddies.
Your new visa, Harriet?
Revoked. I'll send you a postcard.
Well, like you give a fuck about anyone, Sean.
Jake, your perfect record is blown. John Hopkins won't want to know you. It sucks, but it's fact.
Enough, Sean!
You want your prognosis? Here it is. Fucked! Flatline! Do not resuscitate! Wipe your tears with your cheap-ass scholarship on the way back to Hicksville.
Fuck you.
You're with us, Catherine. Drugs or no drugs, you're gone.
All right, Sean. Hold up. We take him to ER. Let me see what we found.
That makes no difference. It still ties him to us.
And when he wakes up and starts bitching to anybody who'll listen, it's gonna look pretty fucking dismal for us. Trust me.
We dump him outside. There's no connection. And what if nobody finds him?
No, they will.
You don't know that, Kim. Okay, none of you know that.
Oh, yes. That way he still gets help and we're not connected.
Sean, you can drive. Oh, then what happens when Kenneth comes to? If he comes to, you think he's just gonna forgive and forget? You think he's gonna keep quiet about this?
It's his word against ours. We deny everything.
It's easier to do minus some half-assed trachea hole.
We stick together. We never saw him tonight. We weren't here. Nobody. Okay? Harriet's right. Dump him.
Oh, Jesus. This isn't happening.
It's gotta happen. If it doesn't, we're screwed. End of fucking story!
Yes, hi. I'm calling about a patient. Mm-hmm. Kenneth. Kenneth Chisholm.
Are you a relative?
No. No, I'm a friend.
Well, I'm afraid.
Look, can you please just tell me something? Anything about him? Yeah, I'll hold. Seemed our self-indulgent ass-saving debate lasted just long enough to starve him of oxygen to the brain.
People come out of comas, right?
In a lot of cases, yes.
Yeah, but in this case, he consumed high levels of alcohol and narcotics. I mean, in this case, his brain was starved of oxygen for way too long. So let's just be clear, Yoshimi. This isn't locked-in syndrome. This isn't persistent vegetative state. This is deep coma.
We're all upset here, Kat.
Good. So let's just go to Dr. Stegman and tell him what happened.
No! No! Are you out of your fucking mind? Look, this is a shame, okay? But let's be logical. If he's asleep, he can't move. He can't talk. What good does telling anyone do?
It's the right thing to do.
Catherine,
We need to have each other's backs here. We just need to stick together. There's no point in...
No point. Kim, what we did might cause somebody to die.
Keep your voice down. Kim's right.
Don't fucking speak for me, Sean.
Fine, fine. I won't.
You can speak for yourself, Kim. You all can. And we all did. Last night. Ken is in a coma. It's a tragedy. But we can't change that. You talk, Kat, and you'll fuck everyone's life up. And you won't have changed one damn thing for Kenneth. You want to go and confess? Knock yourself out. Good luck finding another scholarship.
But let me be clear. I'll be denying everything.
Right. So if Kenneth can't talk, it just didn't happen.
No, it happened. I will never get away from that. But it's done.
Dr. Harris.
Yeah, and you're one of Dr. Stegman's, aren't you? What are you sorry for?
I've taken an interest in coma care, so I'm sorry. I can't help his patient.
Ah. Let me tell you something. Something that Dr. Stegman won't tell you. In this department, in this hospital, we don't really cure patients, we just manage them. It's all about budgets and box ticking. Advancement is denied, ambition is scorned.
I read your research paper on the transplantation of neural progenitor cells in TBI cases. I'd like to observe his case, if you'll allow me.
Well, you can observe if you want to, but it won't be for long. No relatives would come forward. The prognosis hasn't improved, and he's out of insurance.
You're talking about terminating life support.
Well, once ABR tests have been concurred, yes, that's exactly what we're going to do.
Hey, Kat. Stegman missed you on rounds.
You can have my notes if you want.
Hey. What's up?
They're switching Kenneth off tomorrow.
Thank Christ.
Jesus, Sean. What is it with you?
What?
Too much, Sean.
You okay?
No, no, Kim.
Wait a second. They? Have you talked to someone about this?
We should have helped him.
Hey, Kat.
You're right, okay? We should have. But look at us. Think about the people we can help. For years to come. You're gonna be a great doctor. That's something, huh? That's really something.
Thank you.
segment. I've been researching the latest round of drug trials. I'd be interested in hearing your thoughts. Organ rejection and neural regeneration drugs combine to help stimulate dead mitochondria.
These combinations are in early stages of lengthy testing. I don't think they're going to come up in the exam anytime soon, Catherine.
Hypothetically, though, I mean, these are existing drugs that could help stimulate coma patients, correct?
One day, perhaps. This strictly isn't my field, you understand.
Talk to Dr. Harris.
I'd still like your opinion.
Close your eyes. Come on, close your eyes. Imagine you're looking up at a clear night sky. And what you see is nothing. A few thousand stars visible to the naked eye, a mere fraction of 100 billion stars that make up our galaxy. Point is, there are more neural connections in your brain than there are stars in the whole of our small corner of the universe. You start putting both these drugs into something so incredibly complex. Well, we have to be very, very careful. Catherine, you don't seem your usual self.
I will be. Thank you, Doctor. Shelby?
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Catherine.
Hi.
Dr. Stegman has me running vitals on a new patient, a Kenneth.
Kenneth Chisholm.
Yes.
Has Harris okayed this?
Unfortunately. It means I'll be in and out of here all night.
Oh, he's all yours. Oh, wait. You've got to give this guy a call, a Detective Carter, just in case Kenneth gets any visitors, okay? Don't worry, he won't. I mean, none of them do.
All right. Thanks.
Was having a party?
I'm just the messenger.
I'll have him ready at the funeral.
Gotta love those sexy texts. Listen, if you want to take 5, I'll be fine here.
Yeah, sure.
Long.
Bye.
Hey, phone.
Hey, Cap! Hey, Cap! Wait! Cap! Hey, I've been looking for you everywhere. Where have you been?
Not now, you see me, okay?
Look, just hear me out, Cap. Please, look, all I knew was textbooks and printouts and stupid dummies. Seeing him like that, I couldn't handle it. You tried to help him that night and I just stood there.
Well, it turns out I couldn't help him either. I tried to help him, and it's just not gonna happen. Let's just move on.
Look, Catherine, I'm sorry.
Do you notice anything different about him lately?
I mean,
probably walk by him every single night. Safe home. That's it.
So you didn't know of any problem he might have had with your friend?
No.
Says he doesn't remember a thing. Last thing he knew, he had a nosebleed. Woke up to this.
Just, how could he do it?
You never know what's going on in people's heads. Seemed like a regular guy. Then this. Well, here's my card if you need to get in touch.
Detective Carter, thank you.
Call anytime.
She was gone before I could even.
Kat, you couldn't have stopped him. No way.
Thank you for walking me.
Listen, you sure you don't want to talk or something?
No, I'm fine, really. I just need to sleep. I'm going to be there tomorrow when they turn him off.
Well, you're not going to work tomorrow. No way.
Somebody should be there.
Yeah, well, that someone doesn't have to be you. You got to let it go. Kat. You can't help him anymore, okay? You gotta look after yourself. Stop torturing yourself.
Maybe you were right, Jake. Maybe if I do my job better than I ever have before, then, I can look at myself again.
Oh, wait, listen, I'm gonna go to Hopkins. Find a bed.
Okay.
Why don't you go with me? We can get away. Take some time out.
I can't. I'm sorry. I want to be there tomorrow. Has there been a change in his condition?
Patient showed sporadic brain activity in the night. Probably the result of faulty equipment. It's happened before, it'll happen again.
But he might not actually be brain dead.
I shall monitor him for one more night. Protocol.
For some reason, you can't give this Kenneth thing up. But my life isn't getting trashed because of sleeping fucking ugly.
Yoshimi was murdered last night, Sean. But she didn't have anything on you, so it doesn't even register, does it?
I'll tell you what does register. That cop who busted Walt, he's the same cop they sent when Kenneth was admitted.
I know. I have his card. You want me to call him?
Cute. Once you realize we're all way past bouts of conscience, let them pull the plugs and let it go.
You're a real piece of work.
Have a nice day.
Thank you. surprises, huh? I'm trying to help you. Shelby, I need you to see this.
What's with the blood? You sick nurse. Wanna play games? Why don't we step into my office tonight? Take a closer look at that.
How long we got? Lots of good shit around. Just gotta know where to look. Baby, what you got? Kinky. I like.
found him in the storeroom. I was looking ahead, was melted.
I'm scared.
Come on, one thing's got nothing to do with the other.
What if this has something to do with Kenneth?
Want to say his name a bit louder? I don't think the cops in the next precinct heard you.
Yeah, you might want to ease off the hooch a little, Kim.
Screw you, Steve.
Look, I'm sorry, okay? But we don't want to lose it. We weren't the only people Sean partied with. He kept bad company.
What about Yoshimi? She never did anything.
Yeah, but there isn't any mystery there. We know who killed Yoshimi, okay?
Yeah, but what do you mean, Kim?
I'm just saying, what if somebody knew and they're punishing us?
Like who?
I don't know.
Until a few days ago, they were ready to turn off his machines because nobody gave a rat's ass. And what now, out of the blue, he's got some kind of avenging angel? Christ, Kim, give me a fucking break.
All right, that's enough. This isn't helping, okay? It's weird, and it's all screwed up, but it is not connected.
Hey, Kim, maybe it's creepy Kenny. The all-singing, all-dancing, all-sleepwalking, coma-killing vegetable. How about that, princess? You know what? Maybe I'm next. I'll work on being worried.
Your thoughts?
An increase in pulse, BP.
Look at brain activity.
Heightened electrical activity.
Where?
Angular gyrus.
Which does what?
It's located in the vestibular area of the cerebral cortex. We think it helps link visual input to the brain's touch and balance representation of the body.
Very good. What else? Subjects who undergo electrical stimulus to this region claim to leave their own bodies. They attribute this to the paranormal, out-of-body experience. Utter nonsense. Their perception is simply altered. The body's senses transmitting information to the region remain temporary. Interpretive. Fascinating. We have here a patient spontaneously picking this region. Not just electrical spikes. Seems Mr. Chisholm has more life in him than we thought. I think an MRI scan.
Heightened electrical activity, 105. Stabilizer, 130.
You all right?
I'm sorry, I have to go. To know what happened that night.
I saw the security tape. What I did. Once you see, you can't unsee.
Forget about the tape.
I can't.
Tell me what you remember. You spoke to me, Walt. Do you remember what you said?
I always say, save home. Save home to the ladies. Be good to the boys. Save home. Be good.
And after that?
Don't remember.
You can't remember anything that happened after we spoke.
Blood.
You had a nosebleed.
Yeah.
Can you remember anything else?
Nothing else. No more.
I'd like to go back to my room now.
Come on, pal.
You can't. pretend you can't remember anything else.
Freak dog.
What did you say?
Your methods are deplorable, but ultimately, this breakthrough could prove very beneficial to you, to this hospital, and also to Kenneth and other patients like him.
I've made a terrible mistake.
Yes, you have. But I shall be taking over Kenneth's treatment from now on, and I shall take the credit for the breakthrough. We'll both keep quiet about your unethical behavior, and you still get to become a doctor.
Nope. You don't understand.
On the contrary, something quite extraordinary is happening. Something groundbreaking. I can smell it.
Dr. Harris, something terrible is happening. Out of body. It is real. It is happening. We have to stop.
No, you stop. I have been stepped over in this place more times than I care to imagine. I will not be stepped over by a fucking student.
We have to stop injecting treatment now.
This is my patient. Mine. Do you understand? Go. Everything's fine. Everything's...
No! You can't control him!
I tried to fix things, and I made them so much worse. It all went wrong.
What went wrong?
I injected him with a phase one drug that I thought could help his condition. He killed them.
Kenneth's in a coma. Oh, Kat, it's the pressure. We've all been under a lot of stress.
No, it's happening. He has the ability to take people, to use them. The drugs I gave him are making his brainwaves peak. They're causing some sort of a...
Look at me, Kat. You're talking crazy, all right?
No!
This doesn't make any kind of sense.
Look, the peaks are a result of heightened electrical activity in the angular gyrus. That part of the brain is directly linked to out-of-body experience. This peak happened at the exact same time that Sean had a funnel rammed down his mouth. A goddamn funnel.
So Kenneth's somehow taken over people's bodies and killing us one at a time. Have I got that right?
Yes.
You know what, Kat? I'm gonna get you some sedatives.
Jake! He's not gonna stop. He's gonna kill us all. You, Kim, me, Steve, Harriet. He is gonna get us, Jake, for what we did to him. You don't believe me, okay?
Well, come on.
Do me a favor and lock your door.
son.
What? Get Steve and his family. Find Kim. Check the malls, the clubs. Just find her. Maybe if you guys get far enough away, he won't be able to hurt you.
You should come too.
No. I have to stop him.
Jesus, Vanessa, what are you doing? Vanessa. Vanessa, you're sleepwalking, baby. Hey, come on, don't be frightened.
It's me.
Okay, don't be frightened. Come on. Come on.
No!
Massive internal bleeding, weak pulse. Kim, I'm not gonna lose you.
Miss Thomas, I'm arresting you.
What?
Over here, please.
No, I can't. I need to be car.
Why am I here? How are my friends?
All right, that's enough. You need to start getting your head straight, Catherine. You're in a world of shit. I need to know the truth.
I've already told you the truth.
Tell me again.
Everything.
We had a party. Got ourselves Adderall, Vicodin, you name it. Kenneth Chisholm showed up. So we gave him the booze and the drugs. We thought if he was taking them too, then he couldn't tell on us. But it didn't happen that way. He seized and we panicked. And we dropped him at the ER.
So you injected him with some kind of wonder drug. Try to make up for what you did.
In the beginning, yes. But now the hospital thinks it's working, so they're pumping him with this.
Kenneth, he possesses people?
He infects them. He takes them and he kills. And then he returns to his body and they don't remember anything.
From his coma, he does this.
Look, he is doing this, okay? He is doing all of this.
Kenneth.
Yes. Kenneth.
Coma Kenneth. Just what exactly do you think I can do with any of that?
I'll tell you what you can do.
You can go down to that hospital and you can put a bullet in that sick fucker's head. Or give me a gun and I'll do it.
You'd do that.
In a heartbeat. What is this?
Watch. He got a text, see? Telling him to meet. Meet someone he trusted.
Jake.
Yeah, Jake. Slaughtered him, Catherine.
It wasn't me!
Not Kenneth. Not the goddamn bogeyman. You! So no more bullshit.
That's enough for today, okay, Catherine?
Vital.
All good, Catherine. Rest now.
We go again.
Yeah. We go again. Tomorrow after you get some rest.